I get more and more angry every time I see it, Nicholas.
Do you?
Yeah.
Why?
Partly because they use that shot of Catherine looking stern. And so you sort of know that's where they're firing the arrows.
Yes.
Aren't they?
Well, you never know with trailers, do you? I was once told that when it comes to the big films, you know, the proper feature films, the people who make the trailers have nothing to do with the people who make the film.
Yeah, they're often different companies, aren't they?
Yeah. Mm. And so they just tell them, there it is, go and find the best shots, and that's their trade. Now, whether that's the case here, I don't know. I do remember years and years ago making a film for ITV, big television production, about after the death of Diana, Princess of Wales, Harry's mother. And we were very careful in what we said and did and what had happened, and various theories were put to the test and so on. The trailer, though, the trailer made me flinch, because it sort of made it sound like we were really going to crack this story. We're going to tell you what really happened to Princess Diana and all that sort of. So you never quite know, do you? But Netflix have got a corker here. Absolute corker, haven't they? I mean, the rest of us might be going, oh, dear goodness, do we have to go through this? But having paid, it is said, $100 million, about £85 million for it, they're absolutely determined to get the story out there one way and another.
Goodness, no. I mean, it's not just one documentary. It's a series of six documentaries. Mm. You wonder what on earth... They haven't lived long enough to be that interesting, frankly, have they?
Well, it's like pop stars and so on who produce an autobiography at the age of 21, isn't it? I don't know about you, but I find... I watch Netflix and so on, and a lot of these streamers and increasingly... conventional broadcasters, and they decide they want a series. If they're paying all that money, they want a lot for it. And sometimes they get terribly strung out. I think there'll be quite a lot of it. We all go, do we really have to sit through a lot of this, you know?
Is it all about her?
Well, I think... I was telling you the story earlier, wasn't I? And I'll repeat it again. I was talking to someone who was very much involved in the Duke and Duchess of Sussex's one visit to the county with that title. Very much involved in some time ago, wasn't it? A couple of years ago, was it now? And saying that when it came to the organisation of it, and then the two of them appeared and were taken round to meet people in the usual way... You know, being careful what you say to people, as we now know even more, that it was quite clear, this person who was very much involved in it said to me, the person in charge was Meghan. She was very much the one, and Harry did as he was told, basically. Mm-hmm. And I think most of us will feel that's what's going on here. I mean, she's a Hollywood person, after all. She knows the way the system works. And
this does sort of feel like the biography of a Hollywood couple, doesn't it? It's almost as though they're not royal anymore. They're attacking, or it feels like it might be potentially an attack on the royal family. And yet they're hanging on to their and using their royal titles. It's an odd irony, that, isn't it? If they hate the royal family so much, why don't they just give up their titles and live as private Hollywood people?
Yes, indeed. But come on, it's a commercial world, isn't it? There's a lot of money to be made here, and there's a lot of money to be made. Also, there's a book coming, of course. That's about to drop as well. We were told that Harry was very nervous, certainly while the Queen was still alive, that his grandmother would take great offence at some of the things in it. And then when the Queen actually died, there was a lot of talk then that he wanted that the book, they wanted it back, that he could make some corrections. Now, it seems there is talk that it's sort of going ahead anyway and maybe adding a bit to it. I don't know, seeing the way the wind is blowing. I keep making this point, but I think it is very important. The view of the royal family in this country, by and large, you've been doing some big opinion polls this morning, but when it comes to the royal family, you know, the popularity of the royal family is always very high up there. And yes, I did see a figure, didn't I, about those who sort of trusted Meghan and Harry, or were keen on Meghan and Harry. 7%, tiny. Mm. You take those polls, you do those polls over on the other side of the Atlantic. Very different story indeed. Very different story. Whether that slick commercial packaging, or whether it's because, you know, they're just an attractive young couple and a great story. You can imagine people saying, gosh, he's the Queen's grandson and all that and all that. It's hard to tell. But that is the difference. That is the difference. The market they're operating in there, and it is a market. They are a huge brand. That's what matters to them.